There's definitely a common denominator with oxidative stress and inflammation in both autism and schizophrenia, but also in depression. And this is another, you know, brain dysfunction, I guess, if you want to call it that. But inflammation has been shown now to play actually a major causal role in depression. And there's been some animal studies that you may have seen where the sulforaphane, broccoli sprout extract and sulforaphane have shown to be even as good as fluoxetine, which is Prozac, in alleviating like all these different, you know, methods of stress they have to make an animal depressed, and then they give it Prozac or broccoli sprout extract, and it worked just as well, which is extremely interesting.
I totally agree. We won't talk about the way those experiments are done here because I think they can be sort of
inhumane.
distressing to hear about, but needless to say, it's better to do them on mice than on people. So those, in fact, just last week, I was at the Stanley Medical Research Institute, had its annual meeting in Baltimore, and there was a lot of talk about inflammation and depression. They're focusing on bipolar disorder and schizophrenia, and in fact, they funded the study at Sheppard Pratt that's just starting, as I say. There's so many conditions that we hope may respond, even if only partially.
Right.
And the fact that it can be a dietary approach is, I think,
wouldn't that be cool?
Instead
of getting on, you know, something with side effects, possibly take, you know, broccoli sprouts or some sort of, you know, broccoli sprout extract or supplement that's out there that's really effective. That would be so, because it's so good for you. I mean, the sulforaphane, the broccoli sprouts are so good for you. So I just would be really excited to see that happen.